Awards, here is Mark Fahaly.
Well done, in second place, the runners-up in our wife-carrying championships for 2002, winning the wife's weight in turkey and other luxurious Christmas goodies. It's Brendan and Kate from Kilray. There's their prize and their silver medals. And the winners of the gold medal, who not only win the title and the gold medals, but they win the chance to be pampered for a weekend at a health spa. Michelle, you're going to this health spa with someone else. Now, it's up to you. Do you want to take your husband to the health spa or the man who carried you?
I'll go. Oh,
that's right.
Okay, it's Mark then. Well done. She's taking Mark to the health spa. Congratulations to Michelle and to Luke, the 2002 wife-carrying champions. The fastest losers in the wife-carrying, the team who came third, are here with us tonight. Eric and Shona, there they are. Hello to you, congratulations. Eric's from France, so as we say, félicitations. That's what we say in Craig Allen.
They have a banger in their team.
And they have won what is probably the most appropriate wife-carrying prize of all. They have won the wife's weight in beer. Hey. I think we can have a look at it. Well done to them.
And if you have any problem, give us a shout.
If I look fat, I'll keep eating.
Who hasn't swapped yet, Brian and Mark? Brian, what have you got?
I had three things in one, but I had a half-eaten Murray Mint, but I ate the other half because I was hungry.
All right.
I have got, this is my emergency packet of brown sauce that I bring, because in places like Malaysia and Sligo, they don't have brown sauce. So I carry this as well. Oh, and also, the best one of all is I'm going to give my Garrett Gates album, which is actually signed by Philip Gates, which is Garrett's cousin.
That's a great swap.
It's not bad.
That's unique. Mark,
so
what's yours?
Something good this time.
I just got a black t-shirt.
But who owns the black t-shirt, Mark?
To Brian. It's my black t-shirt.
There you
this
go.
Is actually the only interesting thing about this t-shirt is that I wore it on every single, well, not every single day, but most
That's
of the days.
That's Denise Young's, Will Young's aunties.
Yeah. No, I wore this on the tour, including the Belfast tour and all that, you know, all the in the round tour, basically. I wore it every night, so.
That's a great swap. So
that's been
t-shirt
all over the world for us, and it probably it probably doesn't smell the best, but it has been washed, so.
Probably better than it doesn't smell the best.
I'm looking forward to getting
rid of it. It's time to meet some more celebrity swappers. Let's meet our next celebrity swapper. Number one, shout it out. Who are you? Where are you from? What have you got, please?
Hi, my name is Claire, and I'm from Belfast, and I've bought miniature heels. Because these are my heroes.
There could be a fight at any second with these swaps.
And vodka shots for Brian.
What are they?
Vodka shots.
Vodka shots for Brian.
Vodka shots. I love them.
Right. How old are you?
I'm 13.
You shouldn't have vodka shots.
I'll tell you what, I won't swap with you, but I'll see you outside in about 10 minutes.
And number two, madam, standing on the furniture. Hello, who are you?
Niamh.
And where are you from, Niamh?
From Mummy.
That's fair. No, that's fair.
That is.
Never have
you can't go wrong with that one. And what have you got to swap with Westlife? What is it you've got, Niamh?
A teddy bear.
A teddy bear. Is that your teddy bear?
A bear.
It's for Molly.
Oh, and you want to swap
Molly.
That?
For Molly.
For Molly.
Oh, that's for Molly.
Molly.
Oh. I don't want it. I was joking.
He doesn't want it.
Number three, who are you? Where are you from? What have you got?
Niall.
Hey, Niall.
Niall, where are you from?
Clady.
From Clady.
He looks like Liam Gallagher.
What have you got then?
There's a picture of me when I caught a fish.
Excellent.
Where
are you
going?
When he caught a fish.
Excellent.
That's a really
good one. I got a picture of me when I caught a cold. Do you want that?
Number four, who are you? Where are you from? What have you got, please?
Hello, I'm Anita and I'm from Clocky. And I bought Brian a bottle of peroxide. Because I know he likes to dye his hair for special occasions. And because it's Christmas, I think it's
are you suggesting that Brian should dye his hair blonde again? Is that it?
I think he should.
Yeah, we can understand why.
I have to say, it's a tough choice.
It is. And we still haven't heard from number five.
Oh,
number five, who
Thank
are
God.
You? Where are you from? What have you got, please?
I'm Rebecca Braniff, and I come from Larne, and I bring in my favourite teddy bear, and her name's Molly.
I know it's your show, but I don't care, I'm doing this. I want to split my prizes in half, right? And I want to give...
Neve?
Yeah, it's that reindeer for Molly thing. You can have my sauce.
Ah.
Okay?
She's very excited. And?
It's going to have to be picture of the fish, in it.
The picture of the fish for the CD. Please, both of you make your way down and make the swap just there, please, Brian.
Oh. Silly you! Silly you! Is that for me?
Yeah.
Are you getting my sauce? Do I get a kiss? Thank you. And there you go. Oh. And that's for you. That's Philip Gates. That's Gareth Gates. Do you like Gareth? There you go. There's lots of good. There's a Merry Christmas. Oh. Oh.
Excuse me, it's just an item for swappers, not for relatives of swappers. Okay, the vodka shots and the heroes. We've got the peroxide and we've got the teddy bear. Which of those three do you
want to go for? The sweets and the drink.
The sweets and the drink. Make that swap, please.
I'll tell you what, you know what, for the 10 of them, we get 10 signed albums for the 10 of them. Is
really?
That fair?
For everyone who made a swap.
There we go.
So all the swappers get a signed Westlife album.
You always have to try and be Santa Claus, don't you?
But it's Christmas, Nicky. If it was Easter, they get fantastic. Nothing, you know?
Thank you. Thanks for doing that.
You were paying for them, but it's okay.
Thank you to all our celebrity swappers. Oh, look, that's great, isn't it?
It is great.
Can I show that to that camera, please? I don't know if you've seen that properly. It's a close-up of Niall, wasn't it?
And he says,
and
I love
fish.
Your song.
And he's written on the back, I love your new song, Miss Unites. Thanks, Niall. That's yours.
Thank you.
And in the spirit of Christmas, I wanted to talk to you and maybe help you out about Christmas presents. I know you guys can afford to buy virtually anything as Christmas presents, but aren't the best Christmas presents the ones that, like these, that come from the heart, the ones
absolutely.
That mean something, the ones that perhaps you've had a hand in making?
If they come from Brown Thomas, they're not bad either.
We are going to now give you the chance to create something meaningful and a piece of treasure that you can pass on to whoever you want. But we want to give it a competitive edge, so would you mind forming teams of Sligo versus Dublin? Would that be all right?
That's not a problem.
Okay, will you please make your way across to make some Christmas presents?
Like five gangsters with the suits, don't we?
Well, it's not for me to say.
I'm gonna have to take our jumpers off.
Okay.
Our jumpers?
Thanks,
you're worried about that jacket, aren't you? To help you along, the man who fed you during that record-breaking launch tour of the UK, and the man who is the top TV chef, Paul Rankin!
Hey!
How's the stomach?
It's good.
I didn't poison you or anything,
no. How's it
going? Okay. Let's empty out. Can we go, John?
Yes, you. Could you explain?
We're gonna empty out
the
bags, guys.
Okay. Do we empty out the contents of the bags?
Yeah. Yeah, you can take
don't
that out as well.
You're not supposed to eat it, Brian. It might be essential.
I'm gonna give them a clue what they're cooking, okay? That's Have you ever heard this song?
You're Frosty the Snowman!
Frosty the Snowman!
Are we making a snowman?
You're making a snowman!
Right, how do we make a snowman?
You're gonna have a bit of fun with this, guys. Have as much fun with the cream as you want. Okay, let's get these out of the boxes, okay?
The clock has started.
Get those ingredients out.
Okay, you gotta trim the top and the bottom of that.
You call that a knife?
There's a knife.
This is a knife.
That's it. Keep it nice and neat now. Keep it nice and neat.
I'm watching.
There's your head. Take the snowball.
Half of it.
Yeah, baby.
Here, this is it.
And I heard these boys were good with their hands, girls. Spread it on all over, look.
All
just
over.
Like this. Like this. Catch. I didn't tell you that. You were listening.
What am I doing?
Nice and neat now.
Ah, don't worry about that.
You start like that, okay?
Is this like Dax works?
Now cut the top off the muffin, and that's the top of your hat, okay?
Ah, right.
What to do?
Well done, Licky. It'll not move now.
There's the top.
There's your hat.
And now you come.
I think Frosty's had a few brandies.
Please, is this edible?
Yes.
Of course it is. It's great.
It's playing the horrible more like it.
Right, what's the next step?
How's yours going, kid?
Oh, no, you do great.
You need to do the eyes and the buttons.
So you're looking for
smarties,
eyes. Okay? I gotta help these boys.
No,
the dubs are useless.
Look. Oh, come on, the dubs.
Look, where's his face?
Where's his face? That's good.
Right, now what?
Scarf. You need a scarf.
Where would you get a scarf?
Here, we fruit winders. Where I'll give this to these guys.
That's easy.
Get your own. There's a scarf now.
What are we supposed to do with the
You're
scarf?
Doing good.
Are we finished?
Don't say that looks lovely.
Scarf.
Frosty is an ugly boy. Here, give Frosty a few freckles.
Time's running out. 10 seconds. Nine.
Frosty has
eight,
no other time.
7, 6.
Get the hat back
five,
on.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop there. Stop.
I think we won.
Okay, Paul. The first thing we need to do is to get your decision. Which of the two do you think did best?
I think they both did a fantastic job. I haven't seen so much raw talent in years, but I would have to, I think Sligo's just edged it.
Okay. But, it's not, Paul, it's not your decision.
Exactly.
The decision is those of the studio Absolutely. Audience. Yeah. So studio audience, let's hear your support for the team from Dublin. And could we have your vocal votes for the team from Sligo? It's a very close thing.
I'd say they beat us fair and square.
But I think you're right, Nicky. I think the winners are the team from Sligo. Thanks very much to Westlife. Make your way back, lads. That's the way it was supposed to
look like that.
And will you please help me in thanking Mr. Paul Rankin. Now, another record-breaking run lined up for Belfast next summer. Is it, as you said earlier, is it important to do better than you've done the last time every time you do something?
Obviously,
like
it's always it's very nice to do better than what we've done before, but I think, you know, like when we played Belfast last year, we couldn't believe the amount of shows that we were playing and how many people were interested in coming to see myself. I think the statistics were like 1 in every 8 person in Northern
That's
Ireland
right.
or something crazy like that, which is like really, really, really weird. But I don't know, I suppose it puts a smile on our face and obviously makes us want to do it again. And this year in Dublin, we're actually going playing Lansdowne Road as well.
Fantastic.
Yeah, so the tickets just went on sale for that on December 14th. And so anybody in Belfast or anybody in Northern Ireland wants to come down to that, you know, it's going to be a great show as well.
That'll Good be morning, a big welcome. When is that?
That's next
27th of June.
There you go.
27th of June. Well done.
Clockwork.
That's great. Your hair, very quickly, because I'm the one person who can ask you about it.
Because you've none.
Exactly.
Will you have a bit?
A bit. It's not mine, though.
You got a Brazilian going on there.
That's it, yeah. It's all extensions. It's not bad. Why did you decide to do that? Was it simply to commemorate Elvis's death, as we've read?
No, not at all. I just got bored. It was just like looking at this big stupid blonde head every time I seen a magazine or paper. I said, "Do you know what? I'm gonna go black because, you know, my natural roots are sandy, blondy brown, sort of
blackish."
So I said, "You know what? I'll kind of give it a black look and see how it looks." And when I did it, first reaction, everyone was like, ooh.
Oh, no, actually, I think everyone likes it.
I liked it from day one.
Yeah,
too,
right?
I started to look a bit like Elvis. My mother-in-law thinks I look like a young Elvis. How young, I don't know.
Elvis, just tell us.
Yeah. Christmas number one, you're not getting involved this year. Why?
We're going to
lose if we did.
is it the scars that Bob the Builder have left? Is that what it is?
That's it. Never again will we ever get involved in that.
The whole Christmas number one thing at the minute is become far too commercialised and far too competition driven. And to be honest with you, we're not really in for competition. You know, obviously we get number ones and that's a big, big part of our career. And obviously it's a big, you know, achievement in our career. But, you know, the whole idea of going up against somebody and putting a big competition out there, it just doesn't seem right to us at the minute. You know, we just prefer to release our songs, you know, where there's not necessarily an awful lot of competition around us. It's easier.
Who do you think will be number one, though, this Christmas?
I think the girls, the pop stars girls will be number one.
The girls should be number one.
The girls are a hell of a lot better than
the boys. You two are saying that. Do you have a vested interest?
Nope.
No.
Are you sure?
A few dinner dates.
I'm positive.
You have no associations with those guys.
We have no associations with
them. We met
them.
The boys have a better chance.
We met them at our party for like a minute.
So, can you confirm the rumour that Shane isn't here because he and Gillian are just getting married right now?
We would think we'd be there if they were getting married, in all fairness.
That's true.
Probably not.
Actually, where is she?
It would have been a great rumour, though, wouldn't it?
It's a good one, actually. We should start that.
They're not getting married.
Okay. Back to that Christmas number one. I know you're not getting involved in that, but you have got a single coming out after Christmas. Would you do that for us?
Of course.
Yeah, would that's you? Right. We're actually doing we're doing double A after Christmas of a song called Tonight, which is on a new song from The Greatest Hits. And then this one we're about to perform, which is Clifford Just Missing Nights.
Great. Please make your way across to do it for us. Thank you very much. Let's hear it then. It's going to be the next single from Westlife. It is their version of the Cliff Richard song, Miss You Nights.
I've had many times, I can tell you. When innocence I trade for company and children saw me crying. I thought I had my share of that, but these miss you nights are the longest. Midnight diamonds stud my heaven. Southwards burning light, the jewels that I your place. Warm winds that embrace me. Just as surely kissed your face. Yeah, those miss you nights.